So to begin this conference, we will hear from Mariano Rosa, who is a coordinator and leader of the Socialist Youth of the MST of Argentina. And after Mariano, we will hear from a ways from the struggle Pakistan.
Bueno, buenos días, buenas tardes, buenas noches. Entiendo que se escucha bien. Ok. Bueno, en primer lugar quería transmitir un saludo muy especial de parte de la coordinación de nuestra corriente internacional, de la Liga Internacional Socialista, en la persona del camarada Alejandro Bodart, que por razones de salud no ha podido dar inicio saludando el evento, pero que bueno, quería transmitir en nombre de él la enorme expectativa y el entusiasmo por este encuentro internacional de jóvenes socialistas que estamos construyendo, que realmente abre una nueva perspectiva para la Liga Internacional Socialista entre la juventud. Yo voy a tratar de ser lo más pausado posible para facilitar las traducciones. Yo creo, en primer lugar, que este evento lo estamos realizando en un momento muy particular, porque el mundo de la pandemia está provocando cambios enormes y posiblemente nada vuelva a ser igual después de la pandemia. Los capitalistas preparan su salida, que es la única que conocen para las crisis y para la mayoría del planeta. Más explotación laboral, especialmente para la juventud, más desocupación y miseria, más racismo, más opresión a las mujeres y las disidencias, más represión estatal y más destrucción de la naturaleza. Pero había una pregunta que muchos se hacían y algunos ya decían que incluso sabían la respuesta, y era si la pandemia, el impacto generado, iba a congelar las luchas, iba a congelar las rebeliones y las revoluciones en el mundo que venían desarrollándose antes del inicio de la pandemia. Y bueno, y llegó la rebelión en el corazón del imperio, llegó la rebelión en Estados Unidos para contestar esa pregunta de manera categórica, y volvieron a las calles con furia las masas del Líbano, y hoy tenemos representantes de ese país y de esa lucha, de esa juventud extraordinaria en nuestro encuentro. En Francia se retomaron las movilizaciones, en Brasil el proceso contra el fascista de Bolsonaro que acumula y acumula fuerza, y en toda América Latina en realidad se empiezan a mover los pueblos porque efectivamente en nuestras luchas no se toman ninguna cuarentena. Y entonces, un rasgo fundamental para marcar de estas rebeliones, de estas luchas que se están retomando en todo el mundo, es el destacado protagonismo de la juventud precarizada, de la juventud estudiantil, de la juventud víctima del racismo y de todas las opresiones, de la juventud que, en definitiva, lucha ocupando el presente en defensa propia y a la vez se prepara para construir un futuro completamente distinto, opuesto, por supuesto, al que le puede ofrecer el capitalismo. Los que mandan en el mundo, sus gobiernos, sus partidos, sus intelectuales, sus medios de comunicación, nos quieren hacer creer que hay una versión buena de capitalismo, que lo que está fracasando es la versión neoliberal, nos dicen, pero que existe un modelo progresista, un modelo humano de capitalismo.
What we have to say is that it's a typical ideological campaign for times of crisis. The goal is to mislead the radicalized youth. It is intuitively anti-capitalist due to their real experience. So they will not adhere to the ideas of social change, of revolution, of socialism. But all they have to offer are words, speeches. They can't secure dignified work or high quality, free universal education, or freedom, or the right to choose, or nature, or anything. They are scared. That's why they revive old reformist ideas of capitalism with a human face. But actually, that is the truth. Even they call us utopians, actually, the true utopia is one that says that capitalism can be changed. The most realistic of all proposals. And that is the main goal we have to propose. They need to reorganize everything. Politics, policies. In closing, because we have lots of countries and organizations that have been called to this conference and that will be speaking, we'd like to propose some ideas for this meeting. In the same manner that the youth has had a prominent role in all the rebellions around the world, we believe that they have to be protagonists in organizing politically beyond everything that is known so far, holding the flags of our main struggles. The fight against job precariousness must be a core idea. The fight in defense of public, universal, lay, free, and science-based education at all levels. The democratic right to organizing universities, schools, the fight against racism in all its forms. That's another central concept. The struggle of the African American community in the United States. The poor neighborhoods in Argentina. Also, it's important to fight against other forms of oppression, the ones at a national level, and also against women and LGBT people. We must incorporate the flag against all state repression and against all expressions of fascism all over the world that they're starting to take place. And that is the answer from one sector, the capitalist sector, against the advance of rebellions and revolutions. We must fight against depredation of nature, of capitalist production and consumption. That is another flag. It has to be a cause of this youth, the support to workers and the people's struggles. That support has to be internationalist, to unify beyond borders everything that capitalists want to divide. So these struggle flags could be a starting point. This is one of our proposals. They could be the starting point of a true program, of a real program that has as a goal to reorganize everything, starting from scratch. So powerful youth organizations in each country and region of the world, and a huge international organization taking the ISL as a starting point of a real tool for all those exploited and oppressed around the world. Our international organization, it's open and welcomes all those fighters around the world. There are many independent young people participating of this conference, hundreds, thousands, even through social media. They're here to get to know us. To all of them, we want to propose these challenges. that we build together in each country, in each region of the world, that tool that will allow us to achieve that dream. That it's actually realistic. That true need that is that we, the people, the workers, the youth, and all the poor peoples of the world govern. With this great historic and current goal in mind, during these times of rebellions and revolutions, is that this conference was created. So happy that we are starting this conference, that it's already a success. Thank you very much, comrades.